Welcome back to another OnlineDrummer.com drum lesson. I'm Nate Brown, and in this lesson, I'm going to be going over a groove called the Constantin beat. Those of you that are a member of the OnlineDrummer.com forum know that I recently went to the NAMM convention in California and hung out with my buddy Dave Constantin, who sat down at a kit and played this groove. So I was like, hey, that's a pretty cool groove. I've never heard that groove before. So I used it in this lesson. So anyway, thanks to Dave Constantin, and you can get this sheet music at OnlineDrummer.com. Also, don't forget to subscribe to the digital edition of Drum Magazine. Starting in March, I'm going to have a lesson every month exclusive to the digital edition, so you can have it on your tablet, PC, iPod, whatever you have. I'm going to start just by playing this bass groove. I like that groove. I like the way it sounds. It's got the syncopation at the end. And what it is at the end is actually a five-stroke roll. You have a double right, two lefts, and then the completion of the five-stroke roll is on the repeat on count one. And it happens to be an open hi-hat. So the hi-hat opens on one and closes on and with the bass. One, and two. Four, e, and up. One, and two. And four, e, and up. Now that's the bass groove, and it definitely has some broccoli to it. But number one, I added a second measure to make it a two-measure repeating pattern, a double broccoli. So let me play number one for you. All right, you can see that the first measure is the same. The second measure adds two open hi-hats and a snare on the E of three. One, and two, and a three. It might be difficult to get used to that second hi-hat on count two. Closes on the and then you've got a bass on the So two, and You might want to practice that over and over until you become comfortable with it. Of course, we can't stop there. So number three, it leaves the foundational groove on the first measure, and the second measure, I'm going to add in an extra bass drum now. All right, so hopefully you could hear that 3/8 and we got two basses in a row, 16th. 3/8 and 4/8 and So you might want to practice that sequence slowly over and over. All right, on to number four. Number four keeps everything, and it adds in an extra bass on the foundational pattern this time. So the first measure, you've got a bass on count three now. Check it out. And just in case things were going along smoothly for you, on number five, I added a bass drum in a really strange spot and awkward, and it's going to take a little bit of getting used to, unless you've already practiced something like that. But for me, I had to do it a few times over and over. I added a bass drum on the second stroke of the left stick, I guess in the middle of the five-stroke roll. So, 4-E and A, 4-E and A. And the hard thing is count one doesn't have a bass drum. It has an open hi-hat. So that sequence, 4-E-N-O-1, is hard to get used to. Take it slow, and you'll become comfortable with it. Let me play that for you. And there you have it. That's this week's Monday lesson. Last week I was in California, so we didn't have one. And this week, we have one for you. Make sure you check out Alex Ribchester's lesson on Wednesday. He's got sheet music just like me, lays down some cool grooves for you. So every Wednesday you can learn something cool, and every Monday you can learn something okay. Go to OnlineDrummer.com for tons of song sheet music. We're going to be adding about one a week. We've already got a huge database of songs. You can request songs, join a forum, all kinds of stuff. OnlineDrummer.com. Keep drumming.